Hey, what is going on, guys? My name is Triforce Addiction, and I think it's time that we talk about the mythic FENNEC and the business practices behind it, because I know this mythic weapon has been sparking a lot of controversy within the community of Call of Duty Mobile. And all this controversy is with good reason, because honestly, the business practice behind this is honestly one of the worst and the most greediest things I think Activision has ever done. And look, guys, even for a mobile game, this is very, very low. I mean, honestly, like, this is probably the worst microtransaction business practice I think I've ever seen in any mobile game ever. I'm sure there's worse out there, but this is something that, like, really just, it just gets under my skin because, you know, usually I'm not someone that really judges Activision's business practices at all. You know, usually I just think like, oh man, I'm okay with this because, you know, all this is optional and it's all cosmetic. We have to remember that. We need to keep in mind that, you know, having this weapon does not give you any sort of competitive advantage. It's all purely cosmetic. Let's be honest, guys. Activision is very well known for its greedy business practices, like, in the latest years. You know, when it came to Call of Duty Black Ops 3, they had the supply drops. You know, basically a loot box system that was basically gambling. But, you know, of course, they made it a little bit better. You know, they start selling weapons and bundles and everything, which is very nice. And I do appreciate that. But, you know, I feel like they're kind of abusing their power when it comes to Call of Duty Mobile. And this is specifically pertaining to, like, just the lucky draws in general. Like, whether it be Legendary or Mythic. Look, guys, usually I don't really complain about the lucky draw, even though I do have a massive problem with it. It's not that I'm okay with it, because, you know, I haven't really spoken about it. But, you know, like, selling a legendary weapon for, like, over $150 is really stupid. I mean, it's very excessive, because, you know, like, if you play Modern Warfare, or, like, even Black Ops Cold War, you know, they have, like, weapon bundles with legendary variants, by the way, for like at least $24. You know, it's nothing crazy. You know, they have special effects, right? You know, in Modern Warfare, they have tracer bullets and they have, you know, basically like limb dismemberments. What made this whole situation better with Modern Warfare and possibly Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War is the fact that, you know, none of the legendary weapons, especially the ones with any sort of tracer bullets or any sort of dismemberment effects, are like behind any sort of loot box system. So you're just able to flat out pay for them and boom, there you go, you have it. But here in Call of Duty Mobile, you have to be spending like over $100 just to get an animated skin with like just a little small death effect. It's really stupid. And you know, like I never said anything until now because, you know, I thought they wouldn't go anywhere beyond this point. I mean, how much lower can you stoop? And that wasn't until the mythic drop for the FENNEC came out. So the Ascended Mythic drop is slightly more expensive than it would be if it was a legendary weapon. You know, usually the max amount that you would have to pay at the very end, like in terms of COD points, was usually like 3,600 or 4,700. But here you have to pay a whopping total of 5,800 at the end. So knowing full well that this is a rarity above legendary, it seemed very understandable to me if it would cost a little bit more in order to unlock it. So of course I was expecting it to be a little bit more expensive, which it was, but what really caught me off guard was the fact that you actually have to buy the features that are supposed to be associated with this weapon, such as the death effects, such as the limb dismemberment, and also just the cosmetic effects. So I think right here, this is where COD Mobile and Activision really dropped the ball. The fact that you actually have to pay a lot more money, which is probably $100 more for all the effects that are supposed to be associated with this mythic weapon, is complete bullshit. So once you have bought the gun, they basically take you to this new screen where you're pretty much introduced to mythic levels. So mythic levels, every level basically involves a new feature with the gun, you know, a cosmetic feature such as, you know, attachment skins and just death effects in general, like yada yada yada. The problem is, in order to actually get these levels, you of course have to do this stupid crate-like system in order to unlock these mythic points, which is honestly the dumbest thing I've ever seen. So the bottom line is that they're making you pay for features of a gun that you already bought. Like, honestly, with the legendary variants, all the death effects came with it. Every single effect that came with some sort of legendary weapon, for example, let's say the color spectrum for the KN44, the death effects already come with the weapon. But here they decided it was a freaking good idea to separate all the effects and all the features and make you actually purchase them with even more money. So that's basically adding insult to injury over here. What makes this situation even worse is that you are not even allowed to grind for these mythic points. So like, you know, if you want to finish a match, you don't get any mythic points for using that weapon within the match. Which is, oh my god, it's so stupid. So basically, you have to pay like another $100 to unlock every single effect that's associated. Me personally, I only went halfway because, I mean, the rest of the unlockable levels are just death effects of a different color. I already have the limb dismemberment in the red color. I don't understand why I have to grind more just to have it in blue. Like, it's stupid. So all in all, you're basically spending like twice as much as you would spend buying a legendary variant from a draw. It's that expensive. Look guys, the lucky draw is enough, honestly. It's already bad enough. The fact that they're making us pay for just extra features of this gun, when in reality all you simply have to do is just let us grind for it manually, it's unreasonable. Activision like shouldn't even be doing this. I can say with absolute certainty that this business practice right here with the lucky draw and the fact that we have to pay for the features is honestly worse than the supply drops. Like, if anything, it makes the supply drops look like a good business practice. Reloading. With all that said, I feel like there are some changes that need to be made for the future. Since we already know it's going to be this expensive, and I know it's Activision and they're not really going to change it in anytime soon. Some suggestions would be that, you know, if you're going to make the mythic draw like this expensive, for the legendary weapons, I feel like they should be sold in bundles now. And, you know, you could sell them for a pretty high price, you know, like 5,000 to 6,000 COD points, you know, which is like $50 to $60. So, you know, it could be a little bit more affordable and we don't have to spend more money when the mythic draw finally makes its way to the game. Look, I understand this, like, suggestion is very far-fetched. I know it may never happen at all. But I feel like this is something that actually does need to happen because, dude, like, it's excessive of how much they're charging us for just basic animated skins. It's ridiculous. So like, you know, also if they're not even gonna do that, at least let us grind for like just the extra features for the mythic weapons. You know, just give us like some mythic points whenever we finish a match. You know, like give us 10 if we win, give us 5 if we lose. Just, you know, stuff like that just to make it a little bit more balanced. Because the fact that we have to pay for these features is just downright stupid. So yeah, I think that grinding for the features of the mythic weapons would be a good idea because, you know, it actually provides a bigger incentive and it gives them more comfort in the fact that, you know, they don't actually have to pay more money in order to unlock all the features that should come with this weapon. Look, that's the way I see it. I mean, plus, like, the fact that I already have Damascus and, like, sometimes there's, like, literally nothing for me to do in this game. Like, if they're able to let me just like grind for all those features for the mythic weapon, I think it would provide a lot more incentive for me to play because now I actually have something to grind for. And look guys, I'm not saying that they should take off that feature where you have to buy all those mythic points by like just chance. You could have that there as an option if you want. I mean, if you want to speed up the process in doing so, you can. And plus, like, it takes like about 1,000 mythic points to unlock everything. So yeah, you could basically grind the gun for a long time. So yeah, with all that said, this is going to conclude my little, I guess, rant and slash suggestion video for, you know, the next mythic weapon that comes to this game. I'm just saying guys, I mean, I know the ideas that I have here are pretty far-fetched, you know, with the legendaries being in bundles instead of lucky draws, and the fact that, you know, they should let us like grind out all the extra features with the mythic weapons. You know, I know it's very far-fetched, I know it may never happen, but, you know, if you guys share this video, maybe they could actually see the feedback, and, you know, maybe they could change this for the future, because right now, this business practice is it's too excessive. I mean, with the fact that I have to buy like lucky draws sometimes, you know, just to make more content within this channel, it's a lot. I mean, even for like a YouTuber that gets like that gets paid or gets like sponsored by like all these different types of companies, like it's still pretty excessive. I mean, like $300 just for a simple skin, like, dude, come on, man. And just keep in mind, guys, like I'm not sponsored or I'm not being paid by anyone. I'm actually like buying all this out of pocket in order to make content for you guys, and I want to continue, but like, I mean, like Activision isn't really making this easy for me or really for anyone that's trying to grow their YouTube channel. I mean, like I spent like maybe $250. I didn't buy every single feature because I felt like I didn't really need to. I just went for the minimum standard. But man, like every dollar I spent on this weapon was it felt like hell. I feel like I knew I was doing the wrong thing, but I did it anyways just for the sake of this channel. Look guys, I'm just saying, man, they need to like make this a little bit like more consumer friendly, because man, like paying for extra like stuff is just it's a little bit absurd. So yeah, I feel like they just need to tone it down a little bit, or just like just simply just let us grind for the extra features and I'll be okay with it. That's all I'm asking. Is that too much to ask, guys? Like, be honest with me. I know a lot of you guys are going to tell me that having, you know, legendary variants in a bundle is a very stupid idea. But what I mean to say with that is that any legendary variant that comes in the future should be placed in a bundle. The rest of the old ones in the past should remain in the past and should never be, like, resold within the bundles, because it in turn basically screws over everyone that bought a lucky draw. So that's what I mean. So yeah, that's what I mean to say. So pretty much all the legendaries from here on out should be sold on a bundle for like a decent price, you know, it's like something like 5,000 or like half the price of a lucky draw, you know, something like that. To be honest with you guys, I don't think that's a really bad idea, because if you think about it, like it'll probably convince a lot more people to buy the legendary blueprints from the bundles, because like if you think about it, if it's only placed at 5,000 to 6,000 COD points, that's like half the price of a lucky draw. So maybe they won't have a problem, or they'll have less of a problem buying them in the bundles compared to buying them in the lucky draw. I mean, I hope that's a good idea. I hope you guys agree with me in the comments. You guys don't have to if you don't want to. But anyways, that's going to conclude the video. I know I rambled on a little bit more than I'm supposed to, but please guys, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more Call of Duty Mobile content. It did cost me a ton of money to get the FENNEC ascended. So yeah, anyways, I'll see you guys next time. Make sure to share this video so Activision or, you know, the COD Mobile developers could see this. You know, share it on Reddit or Twitter, wherever you want, so we could get this video heard, because right now, this is unacceptable. But anyways, my name is Triforce Addiction. Have a wonderful day, guys.